This is for Year 12 methods. It comes out of the VCAR 2014 multiple choice section about simultaneous equations. Remember, I'm looking for no solutions. No solutions means they're parallel and they're not the same equation. So parallel could be infinite or none, and non-parallel means unique. There's a couple of ways that I can test for parallel. One, I can use a class pad 400, use simultaneous equations, but be a bit careful. Sometimes not all the answers come up. Two, I can look at the determinant of the matrix. And three, I can look at y equals mx plus c and compare my m's. Okay, if the determinant equals zero, therefore they're parallel. The general rule for the determinant, it has to be in the form of ax plus by equals c, dx plus ey equals f. So in this particular case, I've got ax minus 3y equals 5 and 3x minus ay equals 8 minus a. Therefore, I've got a times negative a, so minus a squared, minus 3 times minus 3, minus 9 equals 0. A squared equals 9. A equals plus or minus 3. So it could be this one. It could be this one. It could be this one. It won't be those. These are the values for unique, because for it to be parallel, it has to be plus or minus 3. Both of them will give parallelness. I suggest one of them will be infinite and the other one will be none. They both could be none though, so I need to check it. How do I check it? I substitute the values in. So if I make a equal to 3, I would get 3x minus 3y equals 5. This is a equals 3. And I would get 3x, a equals 3, minus 3y equals 5. So that is definitely identically the same. So that's infinite number of solutions. I'm pretty comfortable that B is going to be my right answer, because it can't be A because I get infinite solutions, and it can't be C because that involves A equals 3. If I was to consider A equaling negative 3, that gives me minus 3x minus 3y equals 5 and 3x minus minus, so plus 3y equals 8 minus minus 3. Therefore 3x plus 3y equals 11, or minus 3x minus 3y equals minus 11, and that's a different equation to this one, even though it's parallel. Therefore negative 3 is correct for no solution. Therefore B is my right answer. What does that look like on the calculator? So I've entered it up over here into the simultaneous equations, and you'll notice that when I press XE and I explore the denominators, the only value that it picked up was A equals negative 3. But in actual fact, I should have picked up A equals positive 3 as being a problem as well. Okay, so if I was to do the gradient and use the whole idea of I'm going to use my calculator to solve this, I can take this down and go interactive, advanced, solve, and solve for y. So it puts in the form of y equals mx plus c, and then I'll do the second one as well. And I select it, interactive, advanced, solve, for y. Okay, so one of them has a gradient of a on 3, and if I set that equal to the other one, which has a gradient of 3 on a, and solve for a, get my two answers of plus or minus 3. Now what I'd like to do is I'd like to grab this equation test it. And then go math 3 given a equals negative 3. And grab the other equation. Copy, paste, given a equals positive 3. A equals negative 3 as well, sorry. And execute. I get different equations, but when they're equal to positive 3, I get the same equation, therefore confirming what I had by hand, and B is the right answer.